sun's up and the weather is really nice today. It's actually nice to go outside. But I do need something. I mean, we just can't get out without a mask. I think I know what to do. Yep, this is just what I need. Hello everybody and welcome back to another video! For this DIY, you're gonna need cotton cloth. However, if you don't have one, you can use another kind of cloth as long as it's breathable. Next off, you're gonna need a few pieces of papers. Turn that into a fan to cool ourselves. Nah, just kidding. Next, to make those eyes really pop, you're gonna wanna take your eyeliner pencil. No, wait, what? This isn't a makeup tutorial! Seriously. Now I do hope that is not makeup. Oh good, that's a tape measure. Then next. Really, a sparkly cloth. Are we having a fashion crisis here? Oh wait, you're counting? Okay, it's a ruler. And you have something in there. No, wait. A pair of scissors? It should be illegal to have that there. And a box? A sewing box. And, oh, okay, the garter. With all the jokes aside, I would like you guys to take your paper and a pencil. For this, you're gonna wanna make your pattern, or you can just search from the internet. However, in my case, I just traced them from the screen since my printer broke. But anyway, once you have your pattern, you're good to go. Next, you're gonna wanna grab your cloth. You wanna make sure that it's breathable. And a tip for working with cloth is that it's easier to work with if you have ironed them beforehand. Now we are going to work on getting that pattern onto the cloth. So you're gonna wanna take a few pins for that. And for this, you're gonna wanna fold the fabric into half so that you can create two pieces of the patterns for the mask. Then you're gonna wanna start pinning those down. And once that's done, you want to trace around the mask, but make sure to leave a few centimeters of allowance since the actual pattern is the actual size of the mask. So when you cut that off, you can see how much allowance I made. And I actually made two pairs of that, one for the front and one for the inside of the mask. Then next off, you're going to want to grab your thread and a pair of scissors. So for this, you're going to start sewing along the line where that pin is. For that, I used a backstitch. However, right now, I just can't do that. So we're gonna do some magic. In 1, 2, 3. So, yeah, that was lame, but, well, here we are. So I've done stitching the two pairs of mask layers. So that's what it looks. It's starting to take shape. So since we are done with both of them, what we are gonna do right now is to place them on top of each other, good side to good side. Now for this, you're gonna want to make sure that each side is going to match. I think you get my point. Right now, guys, this voiceover thing is like legit hard. Like, I didn't think that I'd be having a hard time right now. I mean, like, when you're doing this, like, in real time, in your mind, it's like, oh, it's gonna be easy when I record because I know what's going on. But right now, it's like legit hard not to tell you guys what to do. So right now, as you can see, we're grabbing the pins. We're pinning them down because we're so freaking confident that the placement is perfect. Well, let's just say close to perfect because there's nothing perfect, but what's wrong with trying to be perfect, right? Right now, guys, you don't know how much I've been editing and screwing this thing up. Like, I'm legit tired. And I just realized that this fast forward thing was actually really long. However, I'm still gonna do my best to guide you as to how I made the face masks. Well, it's my way because, well, it's my tutorial, so yeah. Right now, you're gonna start sewing the upper and lower portion of the mask. Make sure to leave those sides open though, since in the later part, we are going to insert the garter, which is gonna be for hooking the mask onto our ears. So by stitching those stuff up, I still used a backstitch, and well, moments later, it's all done. Now, yeah, as you can see, it's all stitched. Now for this, what you're gonna wanna do is grab your garter. Just so you know, the reason why I inverted the mask was because I had a problem with the camera placement, but so far I think it's doing well. I mean, like, it doesn't look that weird except for the inverted face mask. So right now we have our garter and tape measure. So what we are gonna do is try to measure how much garter we would use. However, in my case, I decided I would use 7 inches for both sides. And once you've decided how much garter you're gonna use, you're gonna wanna cut 2 pieces of that. That's gonna be one for each side of the mask. And as to how you're gonna place it, you're gonna wanna place the garter or insert the garter inside the mask and stitch it on each corner as to where the garters are supposed to go. I still used a backstitch for this though. At this point, you're just gonna wanna make sure that you stitch the garter onto each corner. You have to leave those two sides open so that you can flip the mask just like what you're seeing right now. And then we're almost done with it. So the sides that are still left open should be closed. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna fold those sides inwards. And you have to try to arrange that, make sure that they come or they appear clean. So arrange it like so. And once you're quite confident with the placement, you're gonna wanna pin that down, and you would need to do an invisible stitch for that. So right now I can't really actually teach you how, but there are other YouTube videos where you can see how the invisible stitch is done, but that's how I did it with the sides. This, starting off the invisible stitch, what I did was start from the inside of the mask. So once you actually start stitching, you can't actually see where I started, much the whole point of an invisible stitch. My point is you can't actually see the tail of that stitch, like no tail. Like most of the time you're gonna see that there's this thing that holds the thread before you continue stitching. You do that method and in the end you can't actually see the tail. As you can see, after that it is nice and clean and neat. On this one side you really can't see any of the stitching, and we're gonna repeat that on the other side so it really looks clean. So on the first side I was actually having a hard time stitching because the garter was moving around, and so for this I pinned down the garter into a part of the mask just to make sure that it would not keep on moving around while I was stitching. So that's a helpful tip. You're gonna want to do that before doing the actual stitching on the sides. And now we are gonna finish off our face mask. So this is it, everybody, the finished product of the face mask. Yay! So it looks pretty good. It's not perfect, but it's good. So this could be another option for you to acquire a face mask, since I know that not everybody is allowed or could go outside their homes like me because there's this specific age requirement. But yeah, so this is one way to save, and another way to acquire something that you may not have at the moment during this pandemic. So yeah. And here it is, my new face mask. And another face mask. Well, I've done other face masks off cam, so yeah, you can check them out in this little clip here that I made. Thank you so much, everybody, for watching this video. If you haven't seen any of my previous videos, better head into my channel. So please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel, and hit that little notification bell so that you would be updated for more videos, more coolness, more awesomeness. So yeah, bye!